Ignatius, the man for others. The 30th of July is observed as World Day Against Trafficking in Persons. In 2013, the UN General Assembly designated the day to raise awareness of the situation of victims of human trafficking and for the promotion and protection of their rights. But what does that have to do with St. Ignatius? In the mid-1500s, St. Ignatius was already reaching out to protect victims of human trafficking. We shall see that later. Tell me, what comes to your mind first when we say human trafficking? Commercial sex, right? Yes, right. But only 50% right. We'll come to that. Human trafficking is the business of stealing human freedom for profit. It denies freedom to around 25 million people around the world.
Sex trafficking. The crime of using force, fraud, or coercion to induce another individual to sell sex. Common types include escort services, pornography, illicit massage businesses, brothels, and outdoor solicitation. Labor trafficking. The crime of using force, fraud, or coercion to induce another individual to work or provide service. Common types include agriculture, domestic work, restaurants, cleaning services, and carnivals. How human trafficking happens. US law defines human trafficking as the use of force, fraud, or coercion to compel a person into commercial sex acts or labor or services against his or her will. The one exception involves minors and commercial sex. Inducing a minor into commercial sex is considered human trafficking, regardless of the presence of force, fraud, or coercion.
Recognizing human trafficking. Let's see a video now to recognize human trafficking. It's not about simply knowing the signs, it's knowing the story. We are called to pay attention to what's happening around us.
They mow our lawns and vacuum our offices, paint our nails and paint our houses. They are in the room next door or the house next door. They're in strip malls where anyone can see them, but most of us don't, because most of us don't know where to look. Until now. In 2017, Polaris analyzed one of the largest human trafficking data sets in the United States. We took the broad concepts of sex trafficking and labor trafficking and broke them down into what they really are: criminal operations within 25 distinct businesses. Now, we know where to find them. Now we can start to understand how they got there, how traffickers work, how the businesses are run. Now, we know. Now, we end it.
Myths about human trafficking. Let's look at some myths around human trafficking. Myth: all human trafficking involves sex. Reality: human trafficking is the use of force, fraud, or coercion to get another person labor or commercial sex. Worldwide, there are more situations of labor trafficking than of sex trafficking. But there is much wider awareness of sex than of labor trafficking.
Myth: all commercial sex is human trafficking. Reality: all commercial sex involving a minor is legally considered human trafficking. Commercial sex involving an adult is human trafficking if the person doing commercial sex is doing so against his or her will as a result of force, fraud, or coercion.
Myth. It's always or usually a violent crime. Reality. Most traffickers use psychological means such as tricking, defrauding, manipulating, or threatening victims into providing commercial sex or exploitative labor.
Myth. Only women and girls can be victims and survivors of sex trafficking. Reality. One study estimates that as many as half of sex trafficking victims and survivors are male, maybe more. Male victims are far less likely to be identified. LGBTQ boys and young men are seen as particularly vulnerable to trafficking.
Shocking facts about trafficking in India. Globally, almost 80% of the human trafficking is related to sexual exploitation. The rest is bonded labor. India is allegedly the hub of these crimes in Asia.
Per data in 2013, the maximum number of crimes, 65.5%, committed in India were related to human trafficking. 31.1% of the crimes were procuration of minor girls.
Every 8th minute, a child goes missing in India. Almost 40,000 children are kidnapped yearly, out of which 11,000 could never be traced.
West Bengal is the hub of human trafficking in India, followed by Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, and Maharashtra. Delhi is the transit point.
Only 10% of human trafficking in India is international. The remaining 90% operates interstate.
Ignatius, the man for others. Did you know, even before the official founding of the Society of Jesus in 1540, Pope Paul III charged Ignatius and his companions to do missionary work in Rome. In 1543, Saint Ignatius founded a house for the reformation of Rome's prostitutes. It was called Casa Santa Marta. In addition to preaching to prostitutes, Ignatius raised funds to support the house and to supply dowries for women who wished to marry. Saint Ignatius's approach was different. It was to seek out prostitutes and offer them an opportunity in which they could renounce their former life, reform, and be reintegrated into society.
We shall now have Sister Christy, who will share with us how we can deal with our domestic workers so that they don't feel they are like labor trafficked persons.
Domestic workers who take care of our household tasks are a valuable part and parcel of our life. Their service to our family is precious. They deserve respect, dignity, and fair treatment. As Christian employers, we have a role to play to uphold their rights, to ensure justice, to recognize their valuable contribution, to treat them with respect and dignity. Even sometimes to become their voice and to extend our solidarity in times of their crisis. With the present pandemic crisis and the prolonged lockdown, the domestic workers are pushed to the worst situation of poverty and even to starvation due to the stigma of being the potential carriers of the virus. Employers are reluctant to take them back to work. I applaud many enlightened and compassionate employers who are paying them during the lockdown. As followers of Jesus, we can indeed make a difference in their life. Let us stop thinking that they are carriers of the coronavirus. Coronavirus is not the poor people's disease. allow them to work in your houses, taking the protective measures. Treat them with dignity. Talk to them gently. Pay them a just wage. Many of you are giving them a weekly off. Truly, I appeal to all of you to do so. I am sure they will be joyful workers and your heart will be joyful too. Thank you.
In the light of the sharing and the information we have just heard, how can I increase my compassion towards victims of human trafficking?
Prayer. Lord, we pray for all those who are victims of human trafficking in our country and over the world. We pray for their freedom and complete healing. We also pray for the perpetrators of these crimes, that your spirit may transform their hearts. We pray for your mercy and forgiveness over those who do not know what they do.
Grant them the grace to turn away from their evil doings and open their hearts to the dignity of personhood, and help them see your face in the people they are hurting. Heal their hurt and pain, O Lord, so that they may not pass it on to others. Open our eyes to the sufferings of people in our midst. May we not be indifferent, but moved to action by the power of your Spirit. Saint Ignatius, intercede for us. Amen.
After this presentation, we will share with you a video by human trafficking survivor Margie Dell, who shares her experience about finding inner peace, forgiveness and freedom. After watching, pause and ask yourself, how did listening to her story make me feel? And how can I, like Saint Ignatius, become a person for others?